TAPEALERT.
Griselda Blanco Restrepo, known as La Madrina, the Black Widow, the Cocaine Godmother and the Queen of Narco-Trafficking, was a Colombian drug lord of the Medellín Cartel and a pioneer in the Miami-based cocaine drug trade and underworld during the 1980s through the early 2000s. It has been estimated that she was responsible for up to 2,000 murders while transporting cocaine from Colombia to New York, Miami, and Southern California. She was shot and killed on September 3, 2012, at the age of 69. At her height, Blanco was one of the richest and most dangerous women in the world, and was the most powerful drug kingpin in the world. She became the first ever billionaire female criminal, ruling her multi-million dollar drug trafficking empire with an iron fist, and becoming one of the deadliest women of all time. Blanco was born in Cartagena, Colombia, on the country's north coast. She and her mother, Ana Lucia Restrepo, moved to Medellín when she was 3 years old. Upon arriving there, she quickly adopted a criminal lifestyle. Blanco's former lover, Charles Cosby, recounted that at the age of 11, Blanco allegedly kidnapped, attempted to ransom and eventually shot a child from an upscale flatland neighborhood near her own neighborhood. Blanco had become a pickpocket before she even turned 13. To escape the sexual assaults of her mother's boyfriend, Blanco ran away from home at the age of 16 and resorted to looting in Medellín until the age of 20. Blanco was a major figure in the history of the drug trade from Colombia to Miami, New York, and California. In the mid-1970s, Blanco and her second husband Alberto Bravo illegally immigrated to the U.S. with fake passports, settling in Queens, New York. They established a sizable cocaine business there, and in April 1975, Blanco was indicted on federal drug conspiracy charges along with 30 of her subordinates. She fled to Colombia before she could be arrested, but returned to the United States, settling in Miami in the late 1970s. Blanco's return to the U.S. from Colombia more or less coincided with the beginning of very public violent conflicts that involved hundreds of murders and killings yearly, which were associated with a high crime epidemic that swept the city of Miami in the 1980s. Law enforcement struggle to put an end to the influx of cocaine into Miami led to the creation of CENTAC 26, Central Tactical Unit, a joint operation between Miami-Dade Police Department and DEA anti-drug operation. Blanco was involved in the drug-related violence known as the Miami Drug War or the Cocaine Cowboy Wars that plagued Miami in the late 1970s and early 1980s. This was a time when cocaine was trafficked more than marijuana. It was the lawless and corrupt atmosphere, primarily created by Blanco's operations, that led to the gangsters being dubbed the Cocaine Cowboys and their violent way of doing business as the Miami Drug War. Her distribution network, which spanned the United States, brought in US $80 million per month. Her violent business style brought government scrutiny to South Florida, leading to the demise of her organization and the freewheeling, high-profile Miami drug scene of those times. In 1984, Blanco's willingness to use violence against her Miami competitors or anyone else who displeased her, led her rivals to make repeated attempts to assassinate her. In an attempt to escape the hits that were called on her, she fled to California. On February 18, 1985, she was arrested by DEA agents in her home and held without bail. After her trial, Blanco was sentenced to more than a decade in jail. While in prison, she continued to effectively run her cocaine business with the help of her son Michael Blanco. By pressuring one of Blanco's lieutenants, the Miami-Dade State Attorney's Office obtained sufficient evidence to indict Blanco for 3 murders. However, the case collapsed due to technicalities relating to a telephone sex scandal between the star witness and female secretaries in the district attorney's office. In 2002, Blanco suffered a heart attack while imprisoned. In 2004, Blanco was released from prison and deported to Medellín, Colombia. Before her death in 2012, the last sighting of Blanco was in May 2007 at the Bogota airport. On the night of September 3, 2012, Blanco died after being shot twice, once in the head and once in the shoulder by a motorcyclist in Medellín, Colombia. She was shot at Cardoso Butcher Shop on the corner of 29th Street, after having bought $150 worth of meat. The middle-aged gunman climbed off the back of a motorbike outside the shop, entered, pulled out a gun, and shot Blanco 2 times before calmly walking back to his bike and disappearing into the city. 16, she was 69. Blanco's first husband was Carlos Trujillo. Together they had three sons, Dixon, Uber, and Osvaldo, all of them poorly educated, and all of whom were killed in Colombia after being deported following prison sentences in the United States. Her second husband was Alberto Bravo. In 1975, Blanco confronted Bravo, who was also her business partner, in a Bogota nightclub parking lot about millions of dollars missing from the profits of the cartel they had built together. The Guardian reports, Blanco, then 32, pulled out a pistol. Bravo responded by producing an Uzi submachine gun, and after a blazing gun battle he and six bodyguards lay dead. Blanco, who suffered only a minor gunshot wound to the stomach, recovered and soon afterwards moved to Miami, where her body count, and reputation for ruthlessness, continued to climb. Blanco had her youngest son, Michael Corleone Blanco, with her third husband, Dario Sepúlveda. Sepúlveda left her in 1983, returned to Colombia, and kidnapped Michael when he and Blanco disagreed over who would take custody. Blanco paid to have Sepúlveda assassinated in Colombia, and her son returned to her in Miami. According to the Miami New Times, Michael's father and older siblings were all killed before he reached adulthood. His mom was in prison for most of his childhood and teenage years, and he was raised by his maternal grandmother and legal guardians. In 2012, Michael was put under house arrest after a May arrest on two felony counts of cocaine trafficking and conspiracy to traffic in cocaine. He appeared on a 2018 episode of the Investigation Discovery documentary series, Evil Lives Here, to recount his lonely childhood. In 2019, he was featured in the VH1 docuseries Cartel Crew, which follows the descendants of drug lords. He also runs a clothing brand, Puro Blanco, that refers to his infamous mother. Blanco was openly bisexual. According to the New York Post, court records show Blanco was a drug addict who consumed vast quantities of bazuco, a potent form of smokable, unrefined cocaine, would force men and women to have sex at gunpoint, and had frequent bisexual orgies. Her favorite possessions included an emerald and gold Mac 10 machine pistol, Eva Perón's pearls, and a tea set once used by the Queen of England. The report continues, in court, it was revealed that Blanco killed three former husbands as well as strippers, business rivals, and innocent bystanders, including a four-year-old boy. According to her youngest son Michael, Blanco became a born-again Christian. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe and hit that notification bell so you can get all the exclusive content. It's TAPEALERT, TAPEALERT, TAPEALERT.